We actually covered this when it first happened. Remember the really, really extreme guy who did this?
Don't know where to park your truck.
I got you.
You got me?
Yep.
Dumb. Bald headed. See, nobody can get around you.
I got you.
Ass.
I got you.
They can't get around you, stupid ass.
I got you.
I'm gonna knock the hell out of you.
I got your tag number.
Got my tag number?
Yep. I'm gonna call the police.
My name?
Well, what is your name?
You know my license. This kid's you.
I got you.
All right, now we all know Pop should have caught them hands as soon as he walked up like that. But he did not, because the man was really, really calm about it. But we got all of the background, we got all of the information, and the guy was actually prosecuted. Let's put up his picture for a mass. You're looking at Mr. David McConnell, 63 years of age, too damn old to be acting in this manner. A delivery driver who parked in the back of a lot to visit a McDonald's was accosted by a racist man in August. This was in Acworth, Georgia. The video did go viral. The Cherokee County District Attorney's Office has now charged McConnell with simple assault and disorderly conduct on August 26. Here is McConnell's target. This is Mr. Terrence Williams. That's the guy who he was assaulting, the driver who captured the attack on video. Williamson says McConnell followed him into the McDonald's in Acworth, Georgia. Furious, he had obstructed the back of the parking lot. Parking lot seen here was large and unoccupied with multiple entrances and exits to get around his tractor trailer big rig truck. He says McConnell called him stupid and then followed him out to his truck for more after Williamson grabbed his food to go. Here is another shot of the parking lot to the south of McDonald's. Once again, what in the hell are you upset about?
Seriously.
David McConnell was arrested the same day, charged with disturbing the peace of simple assault. He pleaded guilty to disturbing the peace. Here is the Cherokee County Court Clerk's case record we were able to get our hands on. Williamson says he was disappointed the simple assault was dropped as part of McConnell's plea. He says he felt McConnell pushed up against him while he recorded the racist rant. Here's a quote directly from Mr. Williamson to Indisputable. When I came across the video and I hear part of it, it makes me feel anxious. It was a fear of death, and like, who would believe me? He did go to his car. And with everything going on in this world, I was thinking, is he trying to find a reason to get me to react? So he has a reason to kill me. The way he acted wasn't normal. For not liking how I parked. I do watch Richey's show. So I'm glad, I'm just glad I pulled it out my phone. Well, let me say this, we appreciate that you do watch the program. We are also thankful that you are safe and you recorded it. And I concur with you, the charges should have never been dropped. You have to make examples out of individuals like this within jurisdictions. They don't mind doing this when there's, I don't know, let's say a Crip or a Blood. They say, we'll make an example out of you. Well, how about making examples out of racist people too, all right? Is that something that's not allowed? I don't know. All right, so here is McConnell's penalty. He has to do anger management classes, 40 hours of community service. He has to pay a $500 fine, and he was bailed out on a $1,000 bond. All right, Rick, thoughts here?
All right, so first off, via Atlanta Black Star, the Georgia Bureau of Investigation reports that in 2021, there was about 230 hate crimes reported across the state, with the largest percentage of reports coming from the black community, three times greater than Georgia's white community. So this is an ongoing problem, not just of course across the country, not even across the world, but also in Georgia because of what we have seen in years past. You can't get McDonald's, you can't go running in bright Nike clothes. It doesn't really matter. That parking lot, can we put up that photo one more time so I could take a look at it? Because I've been focusing on different parts of America and how we have the least walkable cities. Can you show the other photo as well? I mean, you could fit, you know, trucks inside, like literal freight trucks. You could maybe fit an entire train station in that parking lot. I am curious if this were to be somebody else, what the reaction would have been. I also have to think, you know, if I'm in this situation, I'm a very patient person because of the scare of you never know what somebody's going to have at any point in time because of lax gun laws in this country. So asking nicely would probably go a long way, but this is an ongoing problem that America knows quite well.
Yeah, very well. All right, we at least have the rest of the story. We have been able to expose Mr. McConnell full mask here because when the story went viral, when the video went viral, his name was not attached. Now it is.